Good afternoon, everybody. I would like to take you along in one of the most pressing issues within the field of planning. And this issue is about how planners can support cities in being sustainable and livable places in a dynamic world. And doing so, I raise the question whether planners are not trying to control the uncontrollable. And as you can already guess, I will argue they do. Actually, the main message of my talk goes a step further. We may have to let go of the ambition to plan our cities in detail at the first place. However, I would like to start with a question. And that is, who of you actually remembers why the 23rd of May 2007 was such a special day? Any guesses? Nobody was married on this day? No? Okay. Well, this is actually the day that for the first time more people lived in cities than in the countryside. And it's actually projected that in 2050 this will be close to 70%. The picture is shown here, São Paulo, and I gave a summer school there last week, and I learned that the city is growing with 1 million people every 10 years. So we are really, this 21st century will be the era of rapid urbanization. And then, of course, the key question becomes, how are we going to plan all those cities in the best possible way? Well, trying to formulate an answer on that question, we have to start with, why do we actually plan cities? Well, cities have a big impact on our quality of life. And therefore, planners try to make them better places to stay, to work, and to live. And doing so, they face a complicated task. They have to tackle issues related to affordable housing, but also to water management, keeping our feet dry, and also simply avoiding that animals like this show up on our streets. But also, they try to support economic development, innovation, and creativity to improve our well-being and welfare. Okay, the good news is that the Dutch have mastered the profession of planning. They are described by academic fellows from other countries. They describe our nation as a planning paradise. We, with a focus on functionality and efficiency, we carefully figured out how to plan our neighborhoods in the best possible way and to carefully design our polder areas. So, are we indeed really advanced? Does that really mean that the Netherlands is a planning paradise? Well, success is not always given. Many plans didn't turn out the way that was actually foreseen or planned. So a well-known example is the Bijlmermeer, once a symbol of modernity, and now it is already demolished and replaced by something that better meets our current needs. And of course, an example more closer to home, the Blauwe Stad, meant to give a boost to the eastern part of our province, and it never met its expectations, at least not until now. And the funny thing is that we already are so much familiar with this difficulty in our personal life. And therefore, I would like to raise a question, maybe to our president, Mr. Poppema. What kind of profession were you dreaming about when you were 4 or 5 years old?
I think I once said I wanted to be a professor.
You wanted to be a professor? Oh, then you have become quite close. So I wanted to become a police officer. And but let's take the example of a professor. Then, of course, we are not surprised that somehow you run into a situation and you suddenly are the president of a university, simply by the fact that you learn new things, you meet new people, and also that new opportunities arise. So if we take the role of time more serious and the changes it brings about with regard to planning, then how would it work? Well, first of all, we should start with accepting that uncertainties are simply there and that we have to plan with them instead of trying to control them. Well, we can distinguish different types of uncertainties. For example, contextual changes, an economic crisis, or climate change, they definitely have an impact on our cities. But also opinions on in what and where to invest, they change over time too. They are not stable. For example, with the refugee debate. And the final one is that small changes can have big effects. With the Groningen Museum, we got our wonderful icon. But actually, the bridge that came with it might be even more important. It triggered a transformation of the Volkingerstraat. More shops arrived, more people, again, attracting more shops, up to the point that it is now one of our main attractions. And yes, it has been voted to be the best shopping street of the Netherlands. I'm proud. So what does it actually mean, planning with uncertainty? What does that mean for planning our cities? Well, could we actually plan our cities by setting a set of simple conditions instead of a prescriptive plan? Rules of the game. By setting conditions, you allow a diversity of possible futures to emerge. And at the same time, you can secure the quality of that place. Moreover, by not planning every single detail in advance, you're still open to include new innovations. Think of the potential impact of the self-driving car in our cities. Now, the cool thing is that while me and colleagues are trying to further develop this idea on an academic level, a big experiment is already taking place. Ironically, in the city of Almere, based in one of the most planned areas of our nation, actually also part of a plan that was never became fully reality, the polder Markerwaard is there, and they are developing a city district in an organic way, not predefining the shape of plots, the kind of functions that are allowed, or the pace of development, actually it's left open. So no prescriptive plan, the city is planning itself and gets shape over time. So trying to guide development with the help of conditions. What does that mean concretely? Well, for example, you could say you have to produce your own energy. We are doing good research on that here. Instead of predefining the number of solar panels of your roof, but also allowing a range of functions and activities simply under the condition that you do not harm your neighbors. Or by setting a set of basic design rules, allowing you to express your individuality while still contributing to a coherent whole. So planning, guiding urban development based on conditions. That brings me to my conclusions. Cities are dynamic systems and they are very hard to control. And that actually means that we have to look for strategies and tools that take change as a starting point. And now you guys know that this requires a shift from prescriptive plans towards setting conditions in which the city itself can unfold over time. And I have to admit, I wish I already internalized this principle when being on the dance floor, but that's another story. Thank you so much for your attention.